Hey, we welcome you back. You know, after months of speculation, alien-themed festivals around Area 51 wrapped up this weekend without much trouble at all. You remember a few thousand people attended a festival in the city of Rachel, which is the closest community to the Area 51 military base. This whole thing was inspired by a joke Facebook post calling for a raid on Area 51, really a bad idea. More than 1,000 people did visit the gates of Area 51. Partygoers say while they didn't see any aliens, they had a lot of fun. And we are back in the Fox 2 kitchen. Oh my goodness, look at what that we're looking at. You know, today, as we mentioned, is the first day of fall, but it doesn't mean it's the end of barbecue season. I, true confessions, didn't get my smoker out one time, so that's where they come in. Say good morning to Chris Spillman from Texas Roadhouse in Kirkwood. It's Rib Fest time. It, just because the season's changing doesn't mean our palate is, right?
Right, exactly. Everybody loves ribs, and sometimes you don't have a smoker at home, so this is an easy way to kind of get that
smoke
flavor.
That's the problem. I do, and I didn't use it, not once. That's why I'm coming to you guys.
So this is a way for you to be able to get those ribs at home without without having to have a smoker, but gives you that great flavor. And if you don't want to mess with all the stuff we're going to show you today, you can obviously come to Roadhouse.
And you get to throw peanut shells on the floor. I love that. Talk about what RibFest entails. What do we have going on?
All right. So RibFest, during the month of September, we've got $3 ribs on Mondays and Tuesdays. So you can come and try out our ribs for $3 on those 2 days, any Monday, Tuesday in the month of September. So.
Okay. You can also register for prizes like free ribs once a month.
Yeah.
For a year. Party up to 15 people. Do you have to come in store to do that?
You do, absolutely.
You do, yep. Okay. How many slabs of ribs would you say you guys serve during Rib Fest?
Oh,
you're busy.
yeah, so we roughly go through probably 90 full slabs of ribs a week.
Wow.
So, yeah.
Okay, are you eating ribs? Are you sick of them yet, or no?
Oh, no, this is my favorite thing on the menu. These are absolutely delicious.
Is this like secret spices?
So, yeah, this is some seasoning that we have. You can pretty much use any seasoning you like, whatever you like to do as a rub. You just generously put that on both sides of the ribs.
See, some people like to soak it in brine or apple juice, but I prefer the dry rub myself.
Right, so you just get it on there, make sure you get a good rub all the way into it, right? And then you're going to go right into your pan, right? Nice and easy.
And do you do it in the oven or on a smoker? What do you do?
So we do it in the oven. You just add a little water to that and then some of the liquid smoke, which you can get at any store, really.
Oh, nice.
You just want to have it so it's a nice layer underneath there.
So you don't need a smoker.
No, not at all. So and then you put a couple of things of foil on it. You want to make sure this gets nice and tight on there. So the idea of this is that you want to keep all those juices in the pan with you. All right, we'll go right into the oven with that. And then out of there, the magic of TV, you have the ribs that, when you take that off, you'll see they've got this nice glaze to them all the way done. And if they're made the right way, those bones will come right out of there. So just fall off. So once you've done this, you want to chill these in your refrigerator for a few days. What I recommend is like cooking these overnight, about 200 degrees, 225, something like that, 6-7 hours overnight. Put them in your oven. When you get up in the morning, take them, put them in your refrigerator. When you come home that night, they'll be ready for you to stick on your barbecue.
Oh, I love it. So. Then you smack them up with some sauce.
Right.
And what I love to do is make a whole mess of them in advance.
So.
And then you can freeze them and have them whenever you want.
Yep. And then you just take this and put, again, generous portion of that barbecue sauce on them.
Yeah, you've done
this
a few times, Chris.
Exactly.
You've done it a few times, I'd say.
Yeah, make sure you get it on both sides. You want to make sure when you're cooking it on that grill, you get a nice caramelization on those.
Yes.
And it'll turn out beautiful.
Beautiful crust over that, as we see in the final results. So that's happening at Rib Fest, and that's happening at Texas Roadhouse. The Rib Fest is happening in Kirkwood. So go on in and register to win all those ribs. Say hi to everybody there. They will fill your belly real good with ribs. Even though summer's over, doesn't mean rib time is. We do want to let you know that Texas Roadhouse in Shiloh and Edwardsville, they're also holding a fundraiser tonight from 4 to 10. What they're going to do is a portion of the proceeds is going to go to Backstoppers to honor the life of Trooper Nick Hopkins, who lost his life. So there you go. No matter what roadhouse you go to, enjoy it, spend the money, and hopefully you help some folks in need as well. And you'll leave nice and full. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Some good tips for us to do at home. We'll be right back.